potito, sorakija se načuka, ke poluda pak me boli sa. Nenormale, daj svesti se, ti veke nesi detište, stivo tvoj od zavite, ti smrdi ko čorapite. Pa i da me boli se pram, deka ne boli, stenkam jas, stenkam jas. Ako ko me boli, ej duša da me boli, stenkam jas.
What up, legends? So it's about time we delve back into my favorite topic, and that is footbeds. Now, this is the second video in the series of how to fit ski boots. And yes, it has been a little bit delayed. Now, in the first video, we talked about the anatomy and how to make some assessments. And now what we can do is have a closer look at the next most important element. Now, footbeds are an extremely useful tool when it comes to fitting ski boots. Most of the time, the footbed is actually a much more important part than even the boot selection in achieving a good fit. And that is because the footbed is doing one thing that is really crucial, and that is providing stability. So let's start talking about the disconnect there is when it comes to matching up a hard, plastic, rigid piece of footwear and then trying to enclose something malleable and maneuverable like your feet and legs. So a foot is a very complex appendage. Naturally, a foot is a very active thing when it comes to sport and body movement. You're able to move it in all directions at the ankle and through the foot, whereas a ski boot is pretty much the opposite thing. It is quite a fixed element. And all you're able to do with a ski boot is essentially flex it forwards, tip it over to the side, and then pivot it left to right. So there is a serious mismatch in the amount of movement that you have out of your feet and legs compared to the restriction that a ski boot is providing. So this is starting to put enormous strain on your feet and legs. Essentially, you're always fighting against the boot as you're trying to make these movements to be able to ski well. So it's this mismatch which really is the cause of 90% of people's problems in a ski boot. It can be the reason your feet ache. It is also the reason you may be experiencing toe or shin bang. It's also why your boots can feel too small. It's also the cause of a lot of people feeling like their boots are too narrow and they need to widen them. Really, often what's happening is just your foot is fighting against the boot shell and it's causing the boot to feel too narrow. And it also can be a main reason why you can't keep your skis flat. So what we want to look for is the footbed will become the connecting element between your feet and your ski boots in order to deal with these forces in a much better way. It is what's going to accommodate your foot into the best position in order to create the stability and synergy that we're looking for. You might say, well, a foot is naturally quite stable. I stand on them, I run on them, and I use them all day. Now, that is true for most. Now, a foot is quite stable on a flat platform like this. You can see that the big toe and the first metatarsal play a huge role in foot structure, and it's what's holding the foot up and preventing it from pronating further. Now, the trouble lies with ski boot stance. And the reason for this is inside a ski boot, what we're doing to the foot is actually raising the heel up, and we're also restricting the big toe. Now, what this is doing is actually accentuating and hindering the foot structure, and this is what is causing the instability and can lead to a lot of extra pronation. On top of this, we also have people who suffer initially from overpronation. Now, this can be from genetics or previous injury, or excess weight is causing the foot to loosen up and it's collapsing right down and flattening the medial arch. And you can see this causes the ankle to roll inwards. It's also causing the foot to evert outwards. And when we're taking this structurally weakened foot, raising the heel, and then getting pressure down through it, you can see that this can be the cause of quite a lot of difficulties. And this is where the footbed comes into play to become our supportive platform and create the foot stability. And you may think that, okay, well, what if we go to a really wide 4-foot boot option in order to give you back this structure to the toe and first met? Now, in theory, this is great. You've got to think of it like barefoot shoes, you know, having really wide forefoot, allowing foot splay in the front. Now, although that's a really natural and healthy thing to occur in some footwear, when we're talking about skiing, it's different forces through the feet. So if you are in a boot that's too wide up front here, you're just not going to have the control. You're going to feel off the railroad tracks. So having a bit of compression here is generally going to be required for skiing simply by the nature of the actions we're looking for in our feet. Now from here, you can also look at the whole biomechanical kinetic chain as we come upward. Now, with this support, we're getting a more balanced forefoot, a stable and better aligned ankle joint, and this follows through right up to the knees, to the hips, and right through the core and up to the shoulders. So all of this body positioning is something that skiers should take into consideration in order to get the best balance and also be able to keep their skis flat as they're sliding forwards. So subtalar neutral is a term that is describing the foot being held in a neutral position. Now we talked about this in video one and the talus bone being here right centrally located in the ankle joint. Now this talus is sitting below the tibia and above the calcaneus, the heel bone. And when we've got the foot set into a neutral position, this is what's keeping the alignment nice and parallel through the lower half of the leg. Now, the reason that we want to set the foot as close to neutral as possible is because it's going to ensure that you're then interacting with the boot in the best possible way. And the reason why we want to be at neutral is because a ski boot is actually going to be molded into that neutral foot position from the outset. The other benefit that you're going to get with a foot in a neutral position is it's going to handle the compression of the boot a lot easier as well. So what most people think that a footbed does is just raise the medial arch in order to rotate the foot into the neutral position. Now that is not exactly what we're looking to do. Really, when we're looking to support the rear foot, the main point of contact and support to the talus is going to be further back, sitting just underneath here. And the other thing the footbed is doing, besides supporting the rear foot, is also cradling the calcaneus. It's stopping the heel bone from everting. So it's providing support to the rear foot in two ways. So with the support being further back than what you'd expect, and then the heel cradle around the side, are really the two key elements that's keeping this foot supported neutral. The other thing you can think about is the pressure of a footprint. Now it is not evenly distributed over a flat surface. And we actually have three arches to the foot. We have the main medial arch on the side, but then we also have the lateral longitudinal arch along the outside, which is quite a bit lower. And then we also have the transverse arch, which is side to side behind the metatarsals. Now, if you look to add supportive platform to all three of these arches, it provides a great advantage. And again, because my brain always likes to reference construction, the strongest shape in the world is a triangle. Now, what's relevant with a triangle and your foot and ski boots essentially is how your weight will be distributed pressure-wise. So standing on the footbed, you're going to have pressure down at the heel, and it's also going to be to the first metatarsal and the fifth metatarsal. Now, what's happening as we're skiing is you are going to be standing on this as your outside ski is getting pressured. You're rotating onto that first met and driving that power through. And then the inside ski, you're actually supinating. So that is getting pressured at an outside fifth metatarsal. Now, this is essentially diving between the two as you transfer your weight between your skis. Now what we're looking to do in between these three contact points is that is the structure, that is the strength, and then we're looking to fill in all this dead space around it as your feet move. So with support under your foot like this, it is able to absorb so much more shock and force. But a footbed can also become a big hindrance here because when it is too firm, it's not about just locking your foot into place and shutting down any movement. It's more about minimizing excess movement. So what we want to be very mindful of here is you're not just standing on this platform and tipping over like a robot. And if you do, that's some pretty poor skiing technique. But with this, it's also what's going to cause your arches to ache and you're just going to be super inefficient. As I said before, skiing is a very active sport and all of your joints are linked. So if you have a completely locked out ankle, you are just going to have less body control and it's going to be a hindrance to your overall movement. So every foot is unique. They are like special little snowflakes that are made from the infinite and help you navigate the world. They need to be respected and cared for and feel empowered. So it only makes sense that you need a special, unique, customized footbed built right for them, right? Now, a big myth that permeates the whole ski industry is that if you just take the shape of the base of your foot and match that completely with a footbed, this is what's going to create the perfect support platform for you. Well, not completely though. Now, I've licked a lot of feet. I mean, I've fit a lot of feet into ski boots. And they are not as unique as you'd like to think. Now, we all have them. They all do a similar thing. The real key is to get the right support for them. It's not just about matching shape to foot. It's not what we're looking to get out of a footbed. Now, unless you have a really specific situation where you have quite an abnormal shape of foot, or you have a really restricted foot in terms of mobility, what we need to think about with a footbed is how it supports. And the real key is always to then have exceptional stability to the rear foot and then have a little bit of dynamic range in the mid and forefoot. So, if done well and your foot is secured in this better manner, you are then able to handle a lot more foot compression. Now, that leads to some more high performance fit considerations. You could possibly get into smaller shell sizes and also narrower last widths. Now, on top of this, there is a lot of benefits you will also see from having a footbed. So I'm going to start listing them on the screen right now. So you can see that these benefits start to stack up on top of each other, and it really becomes a whole cohesive thing once you get this support platform right. So dynamic foot support is the ideology that Patriot has been built upon. So here is a message from this video's sponsor.
Hey, thanks Craig, but it's me, Craig again, but now from the snow. And I just wanted to take a little bit of time to talk to you about why you should be skiing with these footbeds. Now, everything that we've talked about so far is what is built in to how they are made. They are amazing comfort and support and are really stable. But you can see that there is a camber built in and that dynamic arch, which really allows you to load a lot of energy into them. Now, there are two models on offer. This one is the All Mountain, and it is just super comfortable. It's going to be the daily driver for most skiers. And the other model we offer is the Freeride. Now, this one is a bit more powerful. It's higher arch, stiffer frame, and is loaded with shock absorbing foam. Now, the way you're going to choose which footbed to go for is either you are going to go for your style of skiing or for the arch height. But either one is completely heat moldable if you need to make any adjustments. But the one thing I recommend is go and ski on them for a couple of days to let them bed in perfectly. So, once you're done with this video, head on over to patriotfootbeds.com and upgrade your ski boots today.
So a full custom footbed is one that you're going to go to a ski store and have a boot fitter make up for you. Now, there are several different options when it comes to custom footbeds, whether that be a process of scanning and milling or taking an imprint and molding a blank. Now, here at Jindy Sports, we use the Sidas custom system. It was personally one of my favorites because we can get such a high definition impression of the foot. Now, the way that we make these is you can see they start as a completely flat blank. And what we're going to do is then heat them up. And then we're going to take an impression of the foot and mold them to suit. Okay. So let's just get your feet off to the side. So So there are two different ways that we can take an impression of the foot. The more basic way that you can set this up with these pillows is to actually set the heel and then vac out some air. And then what you're gonna do is drop the forefoot and force it down into place until we have a good position of the foot. Or we can use the way that I definitely prefer to do because it's much more accurate. And that's, we'll create a bit of a platform here with these silicone pillows. The beauty of this silicone is it's just very easy to be manipulated and we can really get the foot into the position we want quite easily. Now the second method I like to employ is I want the skier to let go of all of their weight in their leg. And we're going to use that windlass mechanism from video one. So here we are lifting the toe. We are actually forcing that talus into that central neutral position. And then from there, we drop the heel down, set it into place, vac some air out. And there we have the arch and heel cup in a great position. Forward of the med heads and the toes, we actually don't want to do any molding there. So we're going to get rid of all this material. And then let the foot relax. So that is one foot ready to go. Hold your hand on your knee right there. So I always start by taking this impression of the foot from a seated position at first, and we can see how the foot is looking, how the alignment is. And then what we want to do is ask the skier to also stand up into place and really see if we get any variation. And it's still looking quite good, and we just need to hear if the skier feels good standing on this support. So that's really good. Now all we need to do is wait for this blank footbed to finish heating and we can set it into place in this imprint. And you can have a seat again. All right, so those are heated up now. And this has now become a nice and floppy blank that we can now lift the foot off to one side. We really want to set that heel cup nice and deep to the back of the mold. We want to keep it even from side to side of the heel cup and then get the foot back into place. And this takes several minutes to cool down. Stand up. Cool, bend the knees back and forth and grab a seat. Super nice. Welcome to hell. Or otherwise known as the boot grinding room. So what we're going to do from here is use this blank and we're going to attach some heel stabilizing foam and then we're going to grind this footbed to a nice and flat surface along the heel. So after grinding this custom footbed, now you can see it is reinforced and the angle and plane we're going for is truly flat. So when we're getting that flat angle, it's balanced between each side of the heel cup and it goes on this plane from the heel right through first to fifth met. That's what we're looking to set the foot position to keep that nice and neutral from the mold. Now, other people do tend to get carried away a little bit trying to lift the first met or cant the foot initially. It's something I don't recommend doing too early. Set the foot into place, adjust canting later if necessary. Usually your footbed will do most of the work. Now, the other thing that's really important here is even in my customs, having a bit of flexibility to this. So you can see on this vertical plane, we have that little bit of give through the arch. It's the best thing for feedback, best thing for feel. Once somebody is on top of this footbed and there's weight upon it, we have a nice stable platform, but that dynamic, good feedback to how it's built. And this can be adjusted pretty much by how much bulk we're leaving on the stabilization or how much we scoop out to give it a little bit more forgiveness. And then you'll have footbeds that you can buy off the shelf that come in this pre-molded shape and style. Now, these are actually quite effective and can be a really cost-effective way to give your feet the support they need. Now, 90% of skiers will actually thrive on an option like this. Now, I think I can hear the gasps coming from boot rooms around the world.
How dare you!
But if you are one of the majority of skiers that lives a pretty active lifestyle, you're decently athletic, you are going to go great on a footbed of this nature as they'll do exactly what you need them to do. So ski boots over the last 5 to 10 years have become so much easier to work with and really require less input from a boot work perspective. So the consideration here is what I love about trim to fit drop-in footbeds is their convenience, their ease of use, and also the result you get. But what I tend to not like about a lot of drop-in footbeds is they're really not built just for skiing. A lot of these brands will actually transfer across one of their walking or running models of insole and just say, oh, this one's a skiing option. So this is something that, you know, can be a little bit lackluster in sort of the support it provides in a ski boot. Then we can quickly talk about high-level athletes and their needs in a footbed. Now, what I'm talking about here is generally ski racers, ski instructors, and also very technical skiers with a very carving-focused approach. Now, what they're usually going to need is essentially a little bit different from the rest of us. Free skiing is definitely needing a footbed that's a little bit more focused on shock absorbing and taking a lot of impacts. But when we're talking about high-level carving and very proficient technical skiing, what we're looking to do is actually have quite a minimalist footbed. Now, these people build up a lot of strength in their feet. They spend a lot of time in their ski boots and they're very looking to have some like supple movements and very light feedback. So often what we'll do is create a custom footbed for this person, but we're usually not adding any extra heel stabilization. It's either going to be like this one with a little bit of fiberglass reinforcement for stability in the back, or it's not going to have any posting at all. Now, the difference in mentality here, it's not so much about giving the foot the extra support and comfort and shock absorption. It's all about reducing that lag time of foot to ski movement. So it's really a minimalist footbed that's just going to take away that lag time and really give that subtle feel that that type of skier is looking for. And then it comes to not using footbeds at all. Now, there really is two ways to look at this. Number one is the majority of people that just haven't ever encountered footbeds. They're skiing around on the stock insoles and they really don't realize just how good their boots can be. Now, that really is a massive chunk of people that I'm looking to reach because they're gonna have such a positive effect from getting a really nice footbed in their ski boots. Now, the only other time that I usually can even consider not having a footbed in a ski boot is going to be someone that has serious mobility restriction and their foot is super flat and they're just not going to respond well to having any sort of support under their feet. But that is a pretty rare occasion and those people are going to know about that anyway. All right, so I hope that's been enlightening and we've got some good foundation and concepts here. Now what we're going to move on to next in the next video is actually looking at how we're going to select the correct ski boot to now match your foot once it's been secured into this ideal placement. So join me in that next video. I know this series is taking a while. I think the last one was 3 years ago. So at this pace, we'll probably be done by 2030. And that's when you'll own ski boots and be happy. Thanks for watching. Stay rad. Be a patriot. Signing out.